the context of this match right here is whoever tops the pool avoids New Zealand in the Cup quarterfinals. The prize would be South Africa, who are no slouches, as we know. But New Zealand, being undefeated so far, look very, very good. And a team you'd like to avoid early in the knockouts. Look at that leg drive coming in with the tackle from Gaston Revol. It's a bit of a caginess to the way this match has opened. Usually these two sides, they come out the trap so fast, but maybe it's an acknowledgement of just how good their opponent is. They can't leave any avenue unguarded, but they have done down the short side. Gonzalez goes hunting, but the inside ball for the trailing line, almost from Bukayaro. Tap tackle, offload. Still, Fiji have it. Nathungu doesn't give. And Argentina have a chance to regather themselves, to re-steal themselves. But Fiji are galloping. They're pulling out all the boxer tricks. They go NBA over the top, but just squeezing forward.
Oh, again, another 30 seconds of breathless rugby. First of all, Iskra on this far side sacrifices himself with a despairing effort. He's in the background. He's the one that makes this pivotal tackle. He stayed down for 30 seconds after it. That is an ankle tap of the highest order.
If you can keep an eye on the kickoff.
The ball gets moved across. Talatholo, why not? You've got hands as big as that. Pass it how you like. Unfortunately, it went forward, hence why now Argentina have possession. But already 2 minutes in, and fans' jaws are approaching floors.
We did well, Vix, to pick every bit of class out there. So much going on in that opening passage. And Argentina, deep in their 22. Go to the boots, and they invite Marcos Moneta to head off in pursuit. A little bit of netball style, and Moneta is the beneficiary. Moneta being tracked down by Talatholo. Oh, and this is going to work out for the pale blue and white hoops. Little grins all round. Argentina on the board first.
We have to mention the fact that their footballing skills equate to a World Cup in football, but this is brilliant. Pressure on, Moneta hassles, he hounds. The ball ends up on the floor, but Iskro thinks about putting it on the right foot. That's as deft as you like. Footballing skills from these seven superstars. And there's some tribute, Moneta. Such is his passion for his country. Check this out. He's got the Messi tat on the calf. That's why they're good at football.
Argentina drawing first blood and putting pressure on Talatholo. Fiji looking slippery, Fiji looking fast, Fiji linking up oh so nicely with each other. Bati Lerenga has a clear path to the try line and he doesn't miss.
But he seemed to capture the turf on that far side with about 9 strides, such as the size of it. Looking composed when he scored it, gets the ball speculatively. Reaching forward for it, and just look at his gait, the running style. Batiyenga, yet another one of these precocious talents coming through from Fiji. Wonderful to witness them. We talk about Messi, they've got their own in Serevi, an icon of the sport in the beautiful islands of Fiji. And this is their second home in Hong Kong.
Well, he's a player who's been dubbed the X Factor. Picked up at the start of the year, plays his rugby for Dominion Brother Rugby Club. Got his debut in Hamilton and he's cementing his place with a try on the most hallowed of turfs in Fijian World Series land. Gonzalez, the muscle man, draws three blue jerseys in towards him. And Alvarez is next to take it on. Just lost control in contact there, and Fiji won't mind looking to profit from it down the short side. A little bit of hesitancy from the Argentinians in that ruck contest, but eventually they resource it well, and eventually they manage to get it to Marcos Moneta, who's spinning and gets it to Gonzalez. Really working hard, Argentina, but so are Fiji in defence. Oh, Tatsuk doesn't see the big hit coming out of the blind spot from Temba.
Six Argentinians in 15 metres of space here. They're looking short of options. Moneta's holding his width that wide, but this is great defence from Fiji.
And for a moment, using Mornay Ferreira as a bit of a shield.
It's not a bad idea, to be honest. Get Fijian shoulders flying in it here. As a result of that, momentum stops a little bit. Argentinian penalty. They'll take their time here. They'll try and recoup. We mentioned about that last game against Samoa. Expending huge amounts of energy. Substitutions all important as well.
Time on.
Iscro takes us to touch, and this is just how close it is at the top. Argentina looking to hunt down New Zealand, who, if they win here, they'll avoid in the cup quarterfinal. And Fiji in fourth with big eyes on high positioning. And of course, the Olympic qualification as well. So crucial to both these nations, particularly so Fiji, the double gold medal winning Olympians. At the moment, it's Argentina who are looking the slicker. German Schultz, haven't seen a lot of him in the tournament so far. And just as he's late to the team sheet, he's late to that clear out as well.
Great clamping from Fiji, expecting where the tackle's going to be made and getting those couple of seconds ahead with Argentinian defence. Fiji, the royal blue. Right here, in a very special place for them.
Imagine that clamp like a vice. And Argentina leading by the slenderest of margins. Just a conversion, final play of the first half. Pride, momentum, but also the prospect of avoiding New Zealand for the winner of this one. Fiji, they've got more sevens in them late in this half. A skip and a hop, and Temba takes it into contact. No other Fijians there to protect him, and they could pay the price as Argentina go quickly. Beautiful hands from Los Pumas, German Schultz. Huge try late in the first half.
With the time in the red, it was Fiji's option to keep playing. And once again, targeting that breakdown from Argentina. Three players committed, ball back on their side. And what I love about this is the simplicity. Fast hands, get to the space, keep it real simple against Fiji. Run hard, run straight. And Schultz, the man who perhaps not mentioned as many times as he has been previously, gets an all-important score to end his first half.
Big celebrations all round. And the conversion added as well. Argentina take a 14-5 lead into halftime. Pool A is all wrapped up. We are off to Pool C for the meeting of Spain and Japan. And then two heavyweights, Australia versus USA. Well, a concerned face on one Fijian fan and another just loving life.
Second and fourth of the series. These contests are always tight.
And you heard that from Ben Gollings, the importance of the next try. German Schultz, who got the last try, used sparingly so far. His offload catches a shin, and Fiji have got the ball. The ball that Gollings demanded, beautifully dropped onto the toe and regathered. off to the midfield. Fiji go through the midfield. Fiji go. And Bukayaro just finding the key and unlocking that gap.
What a movement from him. Bukayaro just buying the time with that hitch. He's on the ball so comfortably. And that little movement, it's such a subtle movement, but it just gets on the outside of Schultz and he flies around on it. Exactly as Ben Golling said, next try, restart. That was his demand. He's also right suggesting that Argentina look tired. They do, understandably. However, I probably would contest that. They don't create much. They're pretty good at that, Argentina. So they get the ball back here. They'll continue with their feast.
Latemba pins that conversion through the uprights. Bukayaro, who got the goal, he's had the greatest teacher any student of the game could wish for. Jerry Tuwai guiding him through his early years, the 24-year-old. Big kickoff, and Fiji claim it. They claim it authoritatively. Yes, they're a long way back. Yes, they're on the spin, but they look like they've got full legs and loads of ambition. That's the enormous frame of Ngoni Masi. Look at that contact area, so fierce. The Fiji get the penalty.
It's a bit sneaky there because legs are clamped. So Schultz gets the ball and he's held in. It's like a small package from wrestling.
Well, there's some big, big, beefy tackles knocking around as well with some men who are built like wrestlers. Oh, but they let that one go out of their grasp. Argentina, they've been so good all day. But Talatolo proves one tackle too far. And just like Ben Golling said, Fiji take the lead.
Well, his requests have been met. Get the first score, get the restart, go again. It's exactly what they did. Talatolo shows both of his best requirements there, size and pace. He's got both in an absolute abundance. A real character. Never seen this guy anything other than a big grin on his face. Up to mischief offered. Well, that's wonderful to see. Look at this. Saluting to the sky.
And a conversion to boot moves Fiji to 19. He has been impressive in Fiji's home from home. Well, the kickoff that Argentina have dominated all day is suddenly proving problematic. The wind in these Fijian sails. Oh, nice footwork. Ngoni Masi proving a real handful. All those limbs and levers. A slightly messy presentation just gives Argentina the breathing room that they really need at the moment.
Yeah, gives them that back. I can't think of many people as big as Ngoni Masi that can move that well. And you'd have to go NFL, I reckon, to find someone who's, what, 6 foot six, 6 foot seven?
NBA.
NBA. Worth a challenge.
Incredible athlete. What do you do? What do you do when when he's running at you? You go low, he's offloading, you go up top.
Yeah, the strike later is 8 metres away.
The stand, you get sent to Kowloon.
It's brilliant, mate. It's absolutely fantastic to see this athleticism. Set.
Argentina feeling the pressure. Oh, and they've been penalised for feeding. It's something that the coaches have had a conference with the referees ahead of this tournament. They are going to be watching it. And Argentina have paid the price.
Well, it's understandable to not want to try and hook a ball from a scrum if you've got three giants facing it. The referee's absolutely looking for it. Must be a clean strike from the hooker, a competition. Couple of turnovers against Fiji.
So Talatolo and Ngoni Masi are the two props in there with a combined height of 30 foot tall. And the scrum is easily won. The start, the stop, the restart, recycled. Onwenemasi showing off his long passing skills, and then the footwork coming in from Mbolata. Oh, the escapology of Mbolata. How on earth did he wriggle free from that?
Well, whilst the Argentinians are perhaps asking that question, Bernsey, a lot of them are asking the referee a question. Not particularly a big fan of seeing appeals towards the officials. But the step initially gets the defenders offset. Iskro was asking why it wasn't released. Technically, it doesn't have to be. It's a bit of, again, a grey area in rugby. If no one is holding you, you don't have to release the ball. But in that protest, there was enough time to find his way, continue forward.
Well, there he is, the Harry Houdini of Fiji, and the fans are beginning to rejoice. 60 seconds left and a healthy 12-point lead. Ben Golling's charges have listened to his half-time talk. He knows a thing or two about scoring points around these parts, 276 of them, and his words ringing true as Fiji are in command. Gonzalez still going, still flexing those muscles, still confronting shoulders, and his carry just frees up some room on that left hand side. Not enough gas to finish it though from Odzadzuk. So Argentina will have to go to this edge where Graziano is lurking. Graziano is collecting, hipping and skipping, and Gonzalez, of course, he's there working so hard. Oh, that is a bit of magic there. Watch out. Look at your wing mirrors. Lovely stuff from Argentina. And they will score on the buzzer. It won't be enough. But a magnificent try made in South America, delivered to us here in Asia to delight the fans of the South Stand.
Well, it had a significant strand of Fiji in this as well. Throws the ball inside off a knee, and there it is, through the legs. Panandini keeping that ball alive. And a typical for GMW. Alvarez with the show initially, the big dummy. That ball in the defence. And Bolivamatu, and then out to Otsatsuk. Again, another quite incredible pool game. Yeah. We have been treated no end in pool A here in Hong Kong.
No conversion added to the Odzadzuk try, and well, a pulsating match comes to a close. Argentina 19, Fiji 20.